What was this project about?
The garden originated from the time when the land actually came back to Ngāti Whātua Ōrākei in 2018. And at that point they did a master plan for all the land, and they determined that one of the things they were very keen to see achieved was a community garden which would feed the whānau in the spirit of hua parakore. So a garden which produced good wholesome food for the people, and that's the whole basis of this particular part of the plan, is to produce good wholesome food and hopefully to shift people from fast food to slow food.
Just in regards to what I read in the article about the use of marae and the knowledge of the land, how important is that to you guys in regards to incorporating and the operations of this project?
Look, it's always been the ambition of Ngāti Whātua Ōrākei to keep their mātauranga Māori alive, and part of that, of course, is how they garden traditionally. Because at one time, Ngāti Whātua and indeed other iwi on the isthmus were the biggest producers of vegetables in Aotearoa. So they wanted to make sure that we respected the traditions, and planting by the moon was one of the most important things. So a feature of this garden is that in the centre of the circle will be a compass that depicts the nights of the maramataka, and so that will help us determine when explaining how our tupuna understood their environment. Because they had to understand it to be such successful gardeners. So they knew that sometimes people had higher energy than others, and they tried to utilise that for a whole range of things. So in the middle of this will be a calendar, a big disc that depicts these houses of the moon. And the paths deliberately face east, west and north, south. And that's because while they didn't understand those terms, particularly pre-colonial times, what they knew was that the sun rose over there, and that during summer it would rise far over to the south of east, and in the winter it would be rising far over to the north of east. And that's because Tamanui Te Rā had two wives. He had a summer wife and a winter wife. And so that allowed them, when the sun rose, to know what month they were in. And of course, Matariki told us when that particular constellation arose in the sky, that here we were at the beginning of another year. Some years there were 13 months, some years there were 12, which is why the Matariki appears at slightly different times depending on the year. So to understand that we plant by the favourable phases of the moon. Maramataka isn't as simple as that, because it also relied on observing other tohu, other signs in the environment, when certain things were flowering, maybe when there was more foam on the sea, some of those things. So they triangulated those particular tohu to understand that. So here what we try and do is create a not just a garden, but a site where we can talk about mātauranga Māori, where we can have te ao Māori explained to te ao whānui, so they know, okay, here it's really important to understand why we have these traditions and how valuable that science is. So it's an important thing for us here, and it's part of the expression of our ahikā.
If we just go off that maramataka concept, I understand the formation in relation to the maramataka. Would you be able to explain to us the formation of this marakai?
So to understand the design of this garden, you need to reflect on te ao Māori. And in the Māori world, everything has a whakapapa and everything has Māori. So it doesn't matter if it's a rock if it's a small insect, if it's the kumara who's related to pani, who gave birth to the kumara, who was related to rongo, and that goes back to Ranginui and Papatūānuku. Eh? So understanding all of those things, the way this garden is designed is first of all to reflect that element of Māori, which is energy. Now for me as a designer, I know that energy is depicted by circles. It's been used a lot in a type of gardening called Janissa gardening, but it's also been adopted largely by the people who work with crystals. They understand the energy in this. So the circle is to depict that energy. The rocks you see on the curves came from our maunga. So that's another quite important part to understand, that when we designed this, we thought about that amazing legacy that Ngāti Whātua and others had when they gardened around our maunga, and they cleared off the rocks and so that they had wide swathes of land, and usually that might have been one hapū or one whānau's garden. And some of those gardens came out 2 kilometres from the base of the maunga. So they would have been, maybe there was 3,000 acres of mara kai here, gardened by Māori, certainly in the 19th century. And a lot of that food kept the, certainly the colonial families in kai, but also some of it went off to Poihakana, to Sydney. So that's the other thing I wanted to do here in the design. And then, of course, as I've just explained, the north, south, east, west elements of that can be used to tell us and describe how did our tupuna understand their environment and how did they react to it as a result. Now, the other unique thing about this garden is that it is it follows the principles of hua parakori. So hua parakori, if you like, is producing food without any of those poison sprays or any of those insecticides and fungicides. So we have an entirely organic concept, but also it's really important to understand that the soil itself, Papatūānuku, is like a living organism, full of fungi, bacteria, protozoa, nematodes, worms, that whole thriving life within the soil. And so part of what we've adopted here is really what's been described as the soil food web, where we try and respect Papatūānuku to the extent that we don't disturb the soil unduly. So what we try and do is maintain those populations in a healthy state, because we know that they themselves will be able to increase the amount of nutrient that plants can uptake, and they can actually produce the wholesomeness of this food, which is part of the food sovereignty kaupapa that we're trying to follow here too, that we could be in control of what's in our kai, and we could make sure that the vegetables, which are so expensive in the supermarkets and the like, can be readily available at no cost to our hapū. So we distribute food here every Thursday, look, we probably have 40 or 50 families coming and gaining their food from what we have available at the time. It's going to be watermelon time next distribution, so that'll be a bit of a exciting time. And the other thing to try and keep good wholesome food being produced is we've just started growing microgreens in our nursery, which is associated with our native plant production. And so we have about a, pardon me, about a 10-day cycle where we sow these things like peas and rocket and other things. And these are harvested and they are then put into little packs and distributed on the day as something to supplement the salads. So the design here is really to try and provide a basis on which we might interpret the might be used to explain the pūrākau, the tuku iho, iho of our ancestors. So that's part of that, and you'll see there's the windbreak behind me has 18 posts, and it's quite possible for us to take every second one and in some way depict one of the whetū, one of the stars of Matariki. That would tell the whole story about the maramataka in the middle is the day or the night, where the sun rises, that's the month, and the particular the beginning of the year being Matariki is depicted maybe along the fence. But there'll be much more to this design. We are looking at how do we create a welcoming facade along the front entrance here at Kepa Road. How do we, and there will be a waharoa dead opposite Kupe Street, which links directly to the marae. And there will probably be a series of pō along there, but this is where Ōrākei wants themselves to be open to the world. So they want this to be a welcoming place. They want it to be a place where, yes, they are feeding their whānau, but also people can wander through and begin to understand that Māori world.
Lastly, Matua, especially with the inflation, with the food prices, the gas, how does it feel being able to provide for the hapori, for the community?
Look, it's a wonderful thing to do. I feel a little bad on days when maybe we haven't got quite as much produce to produce, but I know the kaimahi here that work in the gardens, they in the main Ōrākei people, and so they feel very proud to be able to provide this food for their whānau. For me, it's a great thrill to be involved in something that has such potent meaning to me, but also to Ōrākei.
Did you have anything else to add?
Look, I think other than just this garden, part of the development will include the development of a mararongoa, where we will display plants that are used for various treatments. However, rongoa has to be understood in the context of a much wider spiritual connection and also the elements of mirimiri and other practices. So that will be the next garden we develop, and that's just begun. That will also include a weaver's garden. And then there's a sort of saying of amongst Ōrākei, which is kakahuria te whare, adorn the whare. And we're looking at kakahuria tēnei whenua. So this will be an attempt for us to really create a very attractive place where people will just love to visit.